Hello students, on behalf of College Shala, the first edutech platform which will be specifically providing online study materials to the non-engineering and non-medical undergraduate students of the country. I would like to thank all the members that all of us together has made such a wonderful effort for designing the online platform. The presentation will be covering a brief discussion on some topics of the company law. The subject is a part of BCom Honours and General Curriculum under the CBCA system. The paper is for the students of second semester. The materials of the paper company law will be covering all the topics as per the university syllabus, all the relevant provisions of the Companies Act 2013 and its rule, along with recent amendments of 2020 Act has been discussed thoroughly. The material has also taken into consideration explanation of the topics for the benefit of the students undergoing professional courses. The full syllabus have been divided into 5 chapters. The details of the chapters shall be given in the materials which will be available online. The basic importance of the subject company law arises when we think that the subject company law has its importance for the national and international arena when the companies are carrying on its business worldwide. Presently, the multinational companies are having its exposure both in India and in outside India. So whenever we are studying the subject company law, we are associated with some bodies, regulatory bodies. The first regulatory body is the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Security Exchange Board of India, Reserve Bank of India, Register of Companies, and National Company Law Tribunal. These are some of the regulatory bodies which are controlling or having or giving protection to the shareholders, investors, and all other stakeholders. So we thank all the ministries and the regulatory bodies and the law framers who are designing the company laws, the provisions, the regulations, the acts, and related amendments are coming up each day in the Ministry of Corporate website with the object of helping the nation to expand worldwide and also helping the Indian companies either in the form of public or in the form of private, and that is helping the growth of the economy. As we all know that a company needs capital. The basic purpose of capital is in the form of, comes up in the form of investment. We have capital in the form of shares, debentures, debt capital, we have loans, we have public deposits. So company has different aspects of investments. So with the help of these investment, the company are expanding. We have stock market, we have global depository market, we have American depository market, we have a large number of investment portfolios, we have large number of corporate or dealers, as well as we have the National Security Depository Limited depository system of the government, which is also helping the growth and expansion of the company. So whenever we are studying the subject company law, the basic objective of the subject is to learn all the provisions that are coming up, so that when we learn the subject, we are acquainted with all the upcoming amendments, provisions that the ministry is bringing up time to time, and it is intimating to the shareholders through its publications, through its website notifications, etc. We all know that Indian Companies Act came shifted from 1956 Act to 2013 Act, and presently in your syllabus the 2013 Act has been implemented. All the provisions of the 2013 Act will be followed by, is required to be followed by you. But in the last year, this year is 2021, in the last year 2020, last amendment of the Companies Services Act came up, the study materials will be covering all the aspects of the amendments as well as various provisions of the Companies Act and the rules to the Companies Act. Company Act is not alone. Companies Act is supported by various rules of each different sections which comes up in the along with our study, so which helps to make a complete guideline to the shareholders and to the stakeholders with the object of increasing their knowledge, so that whenever they are making the investment or when the company is also making the investment in another company, the provisions must be learnt, it must be read, and it must be understood carefully, and the provisions are required to be interpreted. So now, with the help of the presentation, we will be discussing certain important areas, basically with the object that how and what is the importance of the company law. Now the thing is that this the materials of the course has been specifically designed, and it has been it will be covering the various provisions as per the university curriculum, as well as the students who will be appearing for the various professional examination. They can also go through the materials. It will be covering some of the points also, so that important points which are important for the students and also for the purpose of examination. The total syllabus has been divided into 5 chapters. The chapter 1 is introduction to company, chapter 2 is formation of company, chapter 3 is company administration, chapter 4 share capital and debentures, and chapter 5 is corporate meeting. All the chapters are having equal marks, but it may be that some chapters are little bigger like other chapters according to the weightage of the chapter, the length of the chapters or the topics that will be given. But the thing is that you have to learn all the topics, or you have to, not only for the purpose of examination, you should read and understand the provisions so that you can interpret whenever you will be joining in future the companies, or you will be a corporate manager, or you will be any professional degree holder, so that you can use and utilization of the provisions is most important factor. Not only appearing for the examination is the sole object of the purpose of the learning of the subject. Now in the presentation I have selected unit 4, that is share capital and debentures. This unit is also 16 marks. These are the certain topics that is given in your syllabus. You will be getting all the syllabus in the materials, even in the various website of the university, you will be getting the syllabus. The syllabus has been specifically designed to make or to help the students to learn the various terminology. Now, company, one thing I should say that company law is based on certain terminology and some sections. It is not that the sections must be interpreted wrongly. If you're reading the section, and that section must be understood properly, and it should be written properly. At the same time, you should make a dictionary of the section in your mind, that this section means this, this section means that, so that will help you out to what is the importance of the section. And the terminology comes up, you have to understand each and every terms that comes up in the company law. Company law is not a theoretical paper. It is basically a subject which is related to your accounts. It may be related to your audit. It may be related to your cost. It may be related to any other subject, because company law is a part and parcel of the total system of financial accounting. We cannot evade this subject with the help and proceed further. So therefore, the reason I have taken this topic for the purpose of explanation is that we all know share capital is forming an important part of company. So when we come up to the share capital, as we all know, share we have done application, allotment, first call, final call. So therefore, we all know that share forms a very important part of company. So that is why the basic objective of the selection of the topic, because we are all, I think we are all at this present, as we are all students of commerce, we all know what is a share. Share is certain unit which is given to the shareholders with the object of investment. So it contains a value. So therefore, every company issues shares. So shares will help the company for the expansion. More is the share, more is the share value of the company, the company is expanding or growing or coming up with new opportunities. In the content of the presentation, we'll be covering few portions of the syllabus. I have selected only 6 portions so that it comes up to your knowledge that what is meant by share capital or types of share capital, prohibition of issue of shares at a discount, sweat equity shares, bonus shares, right shares, and ESOP. ESOP means employee stock option plans. These are related to the company law, and it is also related to the syllabus of yours. I have written the relevant section. If you can remember it, it is well and fine. If not, then also it is no problem, but you should know the provisions, what the provisions are talking about. First, we will be discussing the types of share capital. Now, share capital, we all know it has an important aspect in the company's prospects. So when we are talking about shares, share is an asset and it is transferable from one person to the other person and in the manner as present in the articles of the association. Now, students, as you will be learning the beginning chapters or you will be reading the beginning chapters in the my materials, you will be finding that what is memorandum and what is article. Memorandum, in brief, I could tell you that a memorandum is basically a fundamental charter of the company. An article is basically the internal document of the company. So whenever we are talking about memorandum contains 5 clauses: name, object, capital. Like there are 5 clauses. These 5 clauses helps up to understand what the basic content of the company's object or capital or liability or registered office. Now, let us first discuss what is a share capital or what are the types of share capital. I think, students, you have read these concepts in class 12, but it is just a revision to make it clear to all of you that types of share capital consist of basically authorized capital, issued capital, subscribed capital, called up capital, paid up capital. MCQ questions will be coming from the identifications of the type of capital. Now, authorized means the maximum limit which is specified in the capital clause of the memorandum of the company. If a company wants to exceed or expand its authorized capital, it needs to take the permission by the shareholders and by the central government or by the ROC or the ministry. Without proper consent, the company cannot expand the authorized capital. So authorized capital, we can say it is a nominal capital or it is a registered capital. And authorized capital is said also to be the issued capital and unissued capital. Issued capital means, now I said earlier that authorized capital has to be specified in the memorandum of association. Now, when we are coming up to the concept of issued capital, issue means it is coming up to the public. Shares come up where? Shares come up through the share market. There are 2 types of share market. There are primary market and secondary market. Primary market means the new issue market, or which we talked see about as the initial public offer. And secondary market is the stock market. Presently, they are National Stock Exchange, Bombay Stock Exchange. The shares are being traded, or when the shares are getting allotted, from the date of allotment, the shares get listed and it will be coming up in the secondary market. Now, issued capital means the amount that will be subscribed by the public and it will also include the amount of the unsubscribed capital. Let me give a small example. If a company issues 2 lakh shares, out of which 1 lakh is subscribed by the public, 1 lakh is not subscribed by the public. So therefore issued capital is 2 lakh because the company is issuing 2 lakh shares. And subscribed means the amount of shares the people or the shareholders are subscribing to the company or investing in the company for the first time. And 2 lakh is unsubscribed, that remains unsubscribed, and therefore that percentage of the capital is said to be the unsubscribed capital. Third type of capital is said to be the subscribed capital. Now students, I would like to share a very wonderful thing on this concept, that we thank the government for bringing up the provisions of the subscribed capital. Now, subscribed capital means that unless and until the company cannot receive subscription of 90% of the issued capital, then the company cannot allot the shares. Let me make it a very simple again to you, that subscribed capital means that amount of the capital which the shareholders are subscribing, and if the subscription is less than 90% of the total issued capital, the company cannot go for allotment. And if the company cannot go for allotment, in that case the company can not allot the shares, and that has to be refunded by the company to the respective shareholders. Section 39 prohibits allotment of the shares unless and until the minimum subscription is not received by the company. Next kind of capital, students, we are coming up to the called up capital. Now, whenever we are talking about the called up capital, what is basically the called up capital means? The out of the subscribed capital, which is called to be paid up. Called to be paid up means the amount of capital that the company is calling up to be paid up. Out of total subscribed capital, which is the company is calling up to be paid up. Suppose it is 10 rupees shares, 8 rupees is called up. That is said to be called up capital. And whenever we are coming up to the paid up capital, the amount that is paid by the shareholders is paid up. Out of 8 rupees, if the shareholders are paying 6 rupees, then that will be the paid up capital. And if the company or if the shareholder fails to pay the remaining amount, that shares will be forfeited. So that is the importance of the types of the share capital. Now, whenever we are coming up to the next topic of my discussion, is that prohibition of the issue of shares at a discount. This is a very relevant provision that has come up in the 2013 Act. Previously in 1956, shares could be issued at a discount, but presently shares cannot be issued at a discount except the sweat shares, which are discussed in section 53. All other shares can be issued either at par or at premium. And if any shares are issued at a discount, then it will happen, the shares will be considered as void. Now, whenever the company is issuing shares at a discount, there is a provision in the Companies Act that in the specified section 53, that if the company is suffering a loss, then but the company is required to pay back to its equity share creditors, then in that case the company can issue it at a discount to the creditors to pay off the debt. But for that also you require the confirmation of the RBI act, then only you can do it. If there is a breakage or there is a not following the provision, and then you will be penalized. The company and the officers related to the company will also be penalized. In more you will be learning in a chapter, director, the key managerial person, section 251 of the Companies Act talks about the key managerial person includes the director. So every director who is associated with any malpractices or any other officers in office of the company shall be considered to be incurring a default, and that will be making the penalty for the company. So students, you should always consider that Companies Act 2013 contains the provisions of penalty, because whenever you do a crime or you do break the provisions of the law, penalty will be imposed by the government and for which you will be penalized. Next students, we are coming up to a new topic, sweat equity share. This is a very interesting topic and it has been discussed in section 2, subsection 88 and section 54 of the Companies Act. Now, whenever I said earlier that whenever we read Companies Act, we are not reading the Act completely unless and until we really read the related rules that is coming up with the Companies Act. That is, here we will be discussing some portions like Companies Share Capital and Debentures Rule 2014 talks about that what is a sweat shares. Sweat shares means the shares which are given to the company's employees or the directors. Mind it, students, the word I talked about, the directors or the employees, which can be offered at a discount or it can be offered in consideration other than cash. Only I said earlier that shares can be issued at a discount, cannot be issued at a discount, whenever we are talking about sweat shares can be issued at a discount. And if the sweat shares are issued at a discount, it has to be specified to the SEBI, and at the same time, sweat shares can be issued in consideration other than cash also. So why the company issues the share? Because to motivate the employees and because of the intellectual capital they are investing in the company. So whenever we are coming up to the concept of sweat shares, we all know that sweat shares are required to be authorized by a special resolution. Now, what is a special resolution? This you will be finding many times in the company law. Special resolution is a resolution. What is, first of all, we should understand what is meant by resolution. Resolution means the decision that is taken up in the meeting, either it is a board meeting or it is general meetings. Special resolution needs 3/4 consent, or 75% of the members must give the consent for the resolution. If they gave it, then the resolution can be said to be accepted through special resolution. Now, when we are talking about the special resolution for the equity shares, we must think that what is the quantity of the shares, how many shares are required to be issued, what will be the market price of the share, what mode the employees or the directors will be paying for the shares. All details has to be specified into the resolution. And the interesting thing is that the equity shareholders have the rights. According to the rights of the equity shareholder, the sweat equity shareholders will also be considered to be having the same rights equal to equity shares. But there is a very important provisions of the Companies Act contained in the rule of share capital and debentures, that whenever the sweat shares are issued, they are to be issued at a maximum 15% of the existing paid up capital. Beyond that, the company cannot issue it. Why this provision has been given? Because to restrict the company to allot the shares to the directors or value of or 5 crore, whichever is higher. Now, I have given the definition of the employees as per the Rule 8 of the Company's Share Capital and Debentures Rule. It basically means the present and permanent employee, or it means the director or the employee or director of a subsidiary company in India or outside India, and employee or director of a holding company. These are the people to whom the company can allot the equity shares. Now, students, let us come up to the concept of the new concept, the bonus shares. Bonus shares are said to be the free cost shares. These shares are available at free cost, and section 63 discusses the issue of the bonus shares. Bonus shares can only be issued as a fully paid up shares, and it is given to the members, that means existing shareholders of the company. Now, the question may arise in your mind, why a company issue the bonus shares? The basic purpose of the company to issue a bonus share is to capitalization of the general reserve, because when a company earns a huge amount of the profit and the company cannot issue more amount of the shares, then the company can give extra bonus shares to the company. That means bonus shares can be issued out of free reserve or from the security premium account or from the capital redemption reserve. These are the three sources from which the share, bonus shares may arise. Can be issued. Now, what is a capital redemption reserve? Capital redemption reserve that is specifically created for the redemption of the capital. Even if the company is deciding to redeem shares at a premium, the company can use this this account for fund upon this fund for the purpose of redemption at a premium. Now, this is specifically applicable for when the redemption is done for the preferential shares. Now, whenever we are coming up to the concept of the board bonus shares, it has to be authorized by the articles. Number two, that it has to be authorized in the general meeting. Number three is that if there is a default in payment of interest or on the principal, then the company cannot issue bonus shares. It must not have defaulted in payment of any statutory dues, and all partly paid up shares has to be converted into fully paid up for the payment of the bonus shares. And bonus shares, there is another very important concept, that bonus shares cannot be issued in lieu of dividend. That means without paying dividend, you cannot issue the bonus share. If there is extra fund, then only there is a importance of the bonus share. Now, whenever we are coming up to the next topic, that is the right shares. Now, what is a right shares? Right shares are also the shares that are issued to the existing shareholders as a right. So, it is also has to be permissible by a resolution, and there is an amendment to the Companies Act 2020 that the central government has empowered for the issue of the right shares for a lesser than 15 days. That means that whenever we are issuing the right shares, it can be issued below 15 days and maximum within 30 days. It has to be accepted by the existing shareholders. If they don't accept the shares within 30 days, then the company will cancel those shares. And there is a provision in the Companies Act that if the articles of the company specify that if the company does not want to exercise his right, he can transform the right to some other person, and that to whom it is transferring, that person can exercise the right. And the thing is that the board may dispose of the right shares as necessary if the rights are not exercisable within a specified time, but those disposal of the shares will not cause any disadvantages to the company. Next, we are coming up to the last concept, that is ESOP. ESOP means the employee stock option plans. This you will be getting the detail. In brief, I can tell you that employee stock option plan is also a scheme that has been given to the employees, permanent employees. That option means you may take or you may not take. So it can be either in cash or in consideration, other to cash. And the thing is that there is a very good provision in the act that deals in section 62 subsection 1, that the company, if want to increase the subscribed capital, then these are the further issue method, that is right shares, ESOP, these are the further issue method through which the company can increase the subscribed capital, provided this ESOP must not be attached with the conversion of any debenture into equity shares or loans into equity shares. And there is a rule 12 of the provision talk of the rules talks about that there is a minimum lock-in period of 1 year, and the company shall have the freedom to specify the minimum lock-in period. And there is another good provision that there shall be a minimum period of 1 year from the date of the granting of the option and the vesting of the option. That means as soon as you take the option, you cannot exercise it. It has to be exercised within a period of 1 year. Now, students, I have taken only questions that whenever we are talking about multiple choice question, it basically means that now the question always comes up, what we studied, is it clear or it is understandable? These are some of the questions. As the term sweat issue of the equity shares has been defined in which section? So that is the section 22, subsection 88. Now, whenever we are talking about the capital redemption reserve account, for what purpose the capital redemption reserve account can be used? It can be used for the issue of the bonus shares. Third questions I have given that right issue shall be made within for the specified number of shares offered and limiting the time less than 15 days and it cannot exceed more than 30 days. So that is a thing. And minimum subscription, this is a very important MCQ for your examination. 90% of the total issued capital, the shares, if it is not received, the company cannot make the allotment of the shares. So this is a brief covering of some of the topics from the share capital. So thank you, students. Hope you will be expecting very learned sessions from the materials that will be uploaded by College Shala. And best wishes to all of you, and have a wonderful experience from the learning sessions. Thank you.